This is a proposal that I've had a variation of this for the last 15 years because I've seen this grow from when we used to take $200 million out of the motor license fund to $800 million. 80% of the state's population, essentially, is paying for 20% of the state's free police protection. And as a result, are losing out on road and bridge construction. You know, if I just take the $300 million and divide it by 203 state house seats, that's $1.5 million more that could flow into the motor license fund in every legislative district. That paves a lot of potholes. 80% of us are missing out on road funds because 20% want to take home a wham for free police. And at some point in time, I think the 80% will start to hear from their constituents. I mean, just anecdotally, this morning, I walked in to get my blood test, and the doctor walking through the lobby said, "You're dead on." He said, "I'm a Republican and you're a Democrat, but you are absolutely right on this issue. This needs to be done." We've heard from local municipalities that have their own local police department, and when their neighboring municipality that doesn't have a police department has a call, it goes out over the system. The local police officer oftentimes is 2 or 3 minutes from where a burglary is occurring or a bank robbery or a domestic violence call. The state police officer responds and says, "I can make it there in 20 minutes because I'm across the county." So the local police officer from the neighboring borough responds and handles the issue until the state police officer shows up. When the municipality that has the paid police department says to the municipality that doesn't have the paid police department, "Hey, we'd like to be reimbursed for the cost of our police officer spending an hour or two over there in your jurisdiction," the reply is, "No thanks, we don't have a local police department. We don't pay for police, the state police do our coverage." We've had testimony at our hearings from those municipalities that say, "We're tired of providing free police protection to our neighbors." And look, the officer is sworn to serve and protect. He's not going to say, "Well, sorry, that's a mile away, not in my jurisdiction. That person's just going to get beaten to death while they wait for the state police to show up." They're going to respond. But the reality is, those municipalities that refuse to pay for police protection are taking advantage of 80% of the state's population. And eventually, I think 80% of the state's legislators will say, "Yeah, it's time for that to end."